Miss Margaret. It is good to have you here with me to spend quiet time with Jesus together. I am here with you. Together, we will relax ourselves with just being present, focusing on your breath and being aware of the presence. Through your intentional deep breaths, you'll allow your nervous system to relax, then giving way to the vagus nerve to calm your organs, to let go and breathe better, so that being in the state of stillness and prayer, meditation and deep breathing can change your health status when practiced regularly. It's proven that this wonderful habit can heal or improve certain conditions in your body and can definitely change you from the sympathetic state to parasympathetic state. So let's begin. Find your comfort space. Place your body in a comfortable position, preferably in a sitting position. Sink into your sitting space, letting go and allowing your body to melt like wax, starting from relaxing your neck, your shoulders, dropping your arms all the way down, releasing and sinking into your sacrum. Let's take three intentional deep breaths. Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Heavenly Father, I thank you. I am so grateful to be here in quietness with you. I just want to be simple, to know you are here with me in stillness. Nothing much to say, but to have you near me with a grateful heart, to worship and adore your holy name. Blessed be your holy name. I trust you already know my cares, so free me of anything that is bounding me down. Dear Father, allow me to focus on you right here in my peaceful space. Be present and attentive and hear the word of God from the book of John, chapter 20, verses 11 and 12. Then, verses 15. But Mary stayed outside the tomb, weeping, and as she wept, she bent over into the tomb and saw two angels in white sitting there, one at the head and one at the feet where the body of Jesus had been. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" She thought it was the gardener and said to him, "Sir, if you carried him away, tell me where you laid him, and I will take him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Stop holding on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father, but go to my brothers and tell them, I am going to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary of Magdala went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and what he told her. Glorious it is to have given a God of life, a God who was willing to incarnate into human form, dwelt among us, and freely went through cruel beatings, hung on the cross, all alone, left there to die. But his death wasn't an ordinary death. It was to pay yours and my ransom and conquer death. Take a deep breath. Glorious it is that we know and serve a God like no other, who on the third day broke every chain of humankind and Satan and resurrected to give us a new life and a new covenant. Glory to you, Jesus. As the woman witnessed an empty tomb, she believed when Jesus confirmed with her that he is alive. Tell me, dear friend, are you keeping yourself from your resurrection? Life without being resurrected in Christ is death. It is darkness. It is a burden. It is very sad. And it can be dysfunctional. Life at your old tomb and chase the living God of salvation and fulfillment. Jesus clearly said to the woman, I am going to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God. This is a promise and signifies that you belong to God, who is your Father, and that He awaits for you. How glorious this is! Praise be to God. It is with great joy and a cheerful heart to truly understand the phenomena of what God has done for you and me. It is a gift which we can never pay back. And that is the whole point God made. He wants nothing but our hearts and a love relationship, to accept His love in your heart and life. Be quick to take a detour from death to life, from illness to healing, sadness to joy, from addictions to freedom, from confusion to clarity. In Jesus, all things are possible, because He has conquered all things which lead to death and destruction. Take a deep breath. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, Yes, Lord. Lead me not into temptation, for I can be weak. Season and throughout the whole year, stay focused on the Lord, and God bless you.